Alright, what's up YouTube? It's your boy Jamal here. And on this video, I was gonna give like a quick tutorial on how to make pictures. Many people have asked me, how do I make pictures? You know, how do I, make them look so realistic and stuff? So, I guess this video is to kind of show you on how I make a picture doing like what I do. So, first, you're gonna wanna buy like this purple background. And like, if you're on Photoshop, you know, this is a great thing for you. If you're on GIMP, you know, I don't know how to help you like that because I don't work with GIMP. I work mostly with Photoshop, so this is what it's going to look like on Photoshop. So, if I want to get like rid of this background, like your purple background, you might have to use this right here. I mean, some of you already know that, but like, you know, the people that don't. So, you might as well just want to erase that. You know, it'll clear everything up for you. Like, I want to erase all this stuff. Right there. Yeah, you gotta be careful on some stuff because it's gonna might delete it. It's like almost the same color as it. You know, you gotta just like do it one by one. You can actually do it from like this little thing up there, a little part up there. I'm not sure what it's called, but like you can actually just like cut out the stuff that you want to in a certain picture. So like, you know, it'll help you out. So I'm gonna just cut this out and I'm gonna just erase it. Back, and I'm gonna do this side. I'm gonna just go here, boom, 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 and like you just do that for like all of the part that you want that you want deleted. So do this. You know, if you mess up, you know, I don't think you can go back on it, but like you say, if you click over too much and like it just starts tripping, you can actually press undo, and it'll gradually erase like all of the work that like all of the it go back to your thing. Make this a little bit bigger. So all you're gonna do is erase this part right here, and as you can see, it's taking all away this other stuff that was in the background of my picture. And you're gonna want to do this part right here. So I'll put it right there. That. All right, so back what I was saying. Once you get like all of your picture ready and stuff, all you want to do is grab this little arrow up the top, the first one. You're just gonna drag it over to your picture that you want to post it on. So I'm not gonna make a real picture. I might go with some other video, but I'm not gonna make a real picture. But I can show you how to make your picture look more realistic. I don't use to like make my picture look realistic, but I'll kind of give you some steps on how to make the real picture look real. Now this, it could get pretty challenging. It depends on how you want your picture to look out, but you might want to make a new layer. And once you make a new layer, you might want to go to the brush. It doesn't matter whichever brush you're comfortable with, on how you want to choose your picture, on how you want to brush your realistic steps to making this picture look more vivid. Okay, now all you gonna do, you gonna make sure you wanna go to overlay on this right here, this little top thing. And you're gonna wanna just go right here, mainly where the white is. You don't wanna go where the black is because it's gonna make the picture up. It's not gonna look all, you know, good like that. But you're just gonna wanna do like this or something. So once you get that all stylized, you're gonna wanna like blur it some. Doesn't matter which blur you use or how you want to use, like how you want your picture to look. No, it doesn't matter which one you use. Once you get that set aside, you can just put this little capacity to where you want it. I'm gonna make a new layer after that too, and I'm gonna choose black this time. I'm gonna go to my overlay again. I'm gonna just use this right here, black. It might look kind of stupid at first, but you know, it'll start to eventually pop out. And like, once you work with Photoshop more, the more you'll get how it's used, more likely of a percentage. So once you get this, you want to play with it until you make it look like the right way you want it to look. So I think this is pretty cool right here. So I'm gonna keep that one. Now we're gonna work on the legs. Now, with the legs, you wanna make the same thing. Go over it like that. Boom. Make sure it's overlay. I'm gonna blur it. Part, you know, with the dark part, you want to make sure you get parts where it's dark at, mainly. That's all you're focused on, not the light part, because the picture will just like completely mess up if you do that. I'm pretty sure you don't want to do like the hard work you worked on. It's kind of like how you do like the realistic features. So going back into the thing, say if you want to make like your picture smoking or something, you know, have smoke in eyes now. All you're gonna want to do is it doesn't matter which smoke you put, you know, you can put any smoke you want to. It doesn't really matter about that. So I'm just gonna choose like one random ass smoke. I'm gonna get this one right here. Seems pretty cool, G, right here. So I copied it. All you wanna do is just paste it. You don't actually have to save it to your desktop. You wanna do all that shit. It doesn't matter about that. But all you wanna do is you're gonna play with this a little bit. So the thing I use most is screen, because it takes away the background completely. So that helps out pretty awesome. So you wanna like angle it. You can actually just do this by pressing like control and T. So you can just move it, you know, have it like going down, however you want it, man. You know, it's your picture, however you want to do it, you know, you can do it. You know, don't let nobody ever tell you that you can't make no pictures, you know. I mean, everybody gotta learn sometimes, so don't ever let nobody turn you down, tell them so you can't make pictures, all they ugly, you know. You do what you do, you learn from other people. Alright, so going back into it, and if you want to do like actually like making it like more virtualized, like I'm gonna move this right here and say like I always use this on my picture sometimes, like motion blur. You go to motion blur. It actually like helps to like come to fade out a little bit, depending on how you like it. You know, you can play with this one also how you want it. So, you know, it's good with that kind of stuff. Like, you can change it around the capacity, make it look how you want to look. And, this one just shows, like, the color base on you when you do that. I usually use, like, orange or something, so it'll like that. And it just bring out the picture more. It makes it look more holistic. Not a lot, that's not even a word, but... It sounds important like hell, so I'm gonna use that. And yeah, once you do this, your picture starts to come out with more color. I'm pretty sure you don't want your picture looking all basic and stuff. You know, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be fucking boring to look at, but you know, you can add this, just play around with it. You know, it doesn't have to be perfect, you know. So, you know, once you do this, you want to maximize that to the max, so it won't like just sit there and stand out. And you can just, you know, play around with it, make it look pretty awesome. So, you know, this is your picture. You do whatever you want. And, you know, it's how you want to build stuff. So I'm going to just use this. And I haven't figured out, I want to learn one thing. I like make my body look like it's smoking a little bit. So it'd be pretty cool. I'm going to learn that one soon. You know, but you just mainly gotta mess around with Photoshop. And like another thing on how to make your picture look good, you wanna go to this right here. And I usually use the inner shadow because it's pretty good. You might wanna make sure it's black. You can make sure it's just normal. I just left my normal multiply. But you know, you wanna change your size to make it like kind of look like you're like a shadowman or something, like, you know what I mean? And like, you can use Outer Glow if you want. I rarely use Outer Glow, so it's like a rare surprise if I use this. But you know, Outer Glow is just like, if you want to make like, you know, like, I don't know, however you want to do it. But yeah, and stroke is just mainly like an outline. You know, you can make it any color you want to. It could be blue, it could be red, it could be orange, yellow, you know, your choice of decision. So it's mainly how you want to choose it. And this right here, this is pretty awesome, because like, you can make your pictures look more real even with this. I use it sometimes if I want to make a picture look kind of good, you know. And I can just fold around with it. So yeah. And you know, if you just mess around with Photoshop, you know, you can make your pictures look pretty good, man. You know, you can do the same thing with GIMP. You know, it doesn't just have to be Photoshop. You know, as long as you get the right flow of how you want to build your stuff, you know, you can be like that. But you just gotta work with it. It takes time. I didn't learn this shit just right out the box. You know, I had to take time because I used to use GIMP. You know, and then I advanced to Photoshop and it just got like that. So you know, I just advanced like that. So if y'all have any questions, you know, leave a comment on what you want me to work on. You know, I'll get it done and try to get all of it answered best way I can. If I don't answer your question, you know, I'm sorry, man. But you know, I try my best to get to answering questions. You know, that's what it is. But thank you for watching. You know, just ask me if you have any questions. I'll be sure to put a video up. And yeah, peace, man.